H3000 Factory Mk II is a recreation of several of the key algorithms from the H3000 Ultra-Harmonizer effects processor from Eventide. Now, it's a modular interface that's used to combine up to 18 effects blocks together in a huge variety of possible configurations. And we can see the effects blocks when we click the Program button or the Expand button and go to the Program page. Now, it offers pairs of sweepable delays, pitch shifters, filters, mixers, amplitude modulators, also known as VCAs, and it's got an assortment of modulation sources. We've got two LFOs, two envelope generators, function generator, and more. Now, there are 500 presets here to help you get started and tweak your imagination. To start with, we have the global section at the top. We have soft keys, which give easy access to customize the most important preset parameters, all from this top part of the page. Now, each preset can contain up to 16 snapshots, different variations of the underlying parameters. And we also have global snapshots here, which are independent of each preset and just global settings that we can easily recall. And you can see here the soft keys are assigned. And you can click and drag there, or you can grab right from there. And to learn them, it's really simple. When you make your adjustments, just command click, and that's control click on Windows, the different number to store them. But let's go back to current, and we'll just go back to the default setting to start with. Now here we click on this to sync the tempo to the session or project tempo, and we can have any delays in the delay module synced when this is enabled. And we have input and output volumes here, and we have input and output metering that we can toggle over here. So let's put some of this to work on a vocal. Now, I'm pressing the program button. We can see by default, we've got the left input going to the left output with no modulation blocks or processing blocks in the middle. Now, instead of starting from scratch, there are some really useful building blocks here we can use. So I'm going to just call this up, and I'm going to go for a flanger block. And I'll just start by bypassing this. And here's the lead vocal I'm working with.
I don't know what you're feeling, but you can tell me anyway.
And with this.
I don't know what you're feeling, but you can tell me anyway.
So we can see that the input is routed to the delay input for the left side, and the right side is routed to the second delay input, and those are going to the left and right outputs. It's a very simple building block to get you started. So as we click on each module, and these are freely draggable and droppable to reorder them in any way that's meaningful for you. But as we click on each one, we can see the parameters associated. So here, we're seeing that the time of this delay is being modulated, and this one as well. Now, if we go to the Expert tab, we can see an overview of the parameters in each of the modules, and here are those delay parameters without the beat grid showing, but just a numerical display, and there's the pitch shifter, the LFOs, and filters, and so on. Now, on the Function tab, we can set up, and in this case, view the modulation routings. So we can see that for the delay 1 and 2, the function generator, and we can click this to get access to whatever parameter we want to use as the modulation source. And here we can easily assign a soft key if I want, and you can see I just assigned soft key 2, and I can then use this value to adjust the delay time if that's the way I want to route it. However, I'm going to go back to the function generator, but we can also get other real-time MIDI controllers here. And then we can set a range for how much depth we want for the modulation. And here we can see this is set for a fairly narrow range. And these are all the other parameters from the other modules, and we can set up the routings here as well. So back to the modular display here, we can see now that this is being modulated by the function generator. And when we click on the function generator here, this is just kind of like an internal modulation source. We have various parameters that we can set up the shape of it and the speed, the depth. We can sync it to tempo. And we can even have these parameters modulated by a host of sources, including the soft keys and MIDI controllers. And in the soft key setup section, we can adjust the display range to include negative percentages, which is useful for parameters like frequency that range from negative to positive values. So let's continue this patch. We've got a nice doubled effect so far.
I don't know what you're feeling, but you can tell me anyway.
Now I'm going to route this. Instead of going to the output, let's route it to a filter. And then we'll route the filter to the output to start with. And now we have filter parameters to choose from. I'm going to select bandpass, and then we can set the frequency that we want, and I'll go kind of high. I want to get a little bit of movement in the upper part, and we can set a nice deep filter cue if we want to get a nice resonant boost. So somewhere around here should work nicely. And then here we can modulate it. We'll get to that in a moment. Now, the second one, I'm going to also set to bandpass, and I'll set that maybe a bit higher, somewhere around there, but also a nice steep boost so that we can hear some movement when we start modulating this. So let's listen right now.
I don't know what you're feeling, but...
Doesn't sound very different, but here I'm going to take one of the LFOs and route this to the modulation. Now, when I drop that in there, you'll see the assignment here. So instead of dropping the cable, or dragging the cable rather, we can use this menu to make the assignments as well if we want. Now I'm going to take the same LFO and bring this here, and then we'll dial up the depth of modulation we want. Now this moves pretty radically. We can use the Option or Alt key to reset it, and Command or Control on Windows to fine-tune it in smaller increments.
I don't know what you're feeling, but you can tell me.
And we can slow down the rate.
Way. 'Cause you're hurting my feelings. I know you love me. Tell me now, tell me now, tell me now. If you want to get out of my life, but don't like the...
Let's continue this by routing the output to the pitch shifter in. Set up this way, the filter connection is severed when the pitch shifter connection is made. The combined signal from the pitch shifter will be sent to the main output. If we want to blend the filter and pitch shifter in parallel, we can easily route them to one of the mixer modules before reaching the main outputs. So here, we've got some long delays.
I don't know what you're feeling.
So let's set these a fair bit shorter, and we can modulate these too if we want to. But let's set something like that, and for this one, we'll go maybe even a bit shorter, something like that.
I don't know what you're feeling, but you can tell me anyway, 'cause you're hurting my...
And let's take the same LFO and now modulate the pitch as well. So here we can see the LFO appearing for the pitch modulation in, and then we can set the amount.
I don't know what you're feeling, but you can tell
just
me
a subtle
anyway.
Amount.
'Cause you're hurting my feelings, I know.
So I'll set one slightly negative and one slightly positive, and that's going down 9 cents, and we'll start up a bit higher, something like that. So we're hovering around zero, and this one is going up, so we'll start this one a little bit negative, somewhere around there, and we're going through zero, and that should be fine.
I don't know what you're feeling, but you can tell me anyway. 'Cause you hurt my feelings, I know you love me.
We can finally adjust the blend with the mix knob here and then the output volume to compensate. So here's this effect on and off.
I don't know what you're feeling, but you can tell me anyway. 'Cause you hurt my feelings, I know you love me.
That's the H3000 Factory Mk II from Eventide.